E ona nei kororia ki te atua tihei Māori ora. Nau mai, hari mai, ki tēnei whare, karakia, tēnā koutou, tēnā tata katoa. Good morning, everybody. Everyone, welcome to chapel today. Please have a seat if you're stood up. And I'd like to thank Max for playing one of my favourites as we come in. We've not heard that wonderful song, the words or the music of the Battle Hymn of the Republic in this whare for quite some time now. So great to come in to that song. Thank you, Max. Thank you, Sean, our organists for today. So today we've got Sam White leading the service, the final chapel prefect to lead service in term one this year. So Sam is speaking to us on the theme of being you, our uniqueness and our identity. So we look forward to Sam's words in just a few moments from now. And we've got a few extra bits and pieces in chapel as well today with ukulele and other music as well. So let's go to our opening responses. The Lord be with you. This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Ki noi tātou, let us pray.
God, all love comes from you. Warm our hearts with your love, deliver us from all meanness of spirit, and make us generous in all that we do and all that we are. Through Jesus Christ, our Liberator, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
From the Book of Psalms in the Bible, an ancient songbook written over 3,000 years ago, we learn of our uniqueness in the eyes of the one who made us, God. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Your eyes saw my uniform substance. In your book were written, every one of them, the days that were formed for me, when as yet there was none of them. Here ends the reading.
A few weeks ago, Rev told the chapel prefects and myself that we would all have to stand up here and address you before the end of the term. This didn't seem so bad in the big swing of things. All we had to do was stand in front of a camera and an empty chapel, say what we needed to, and sit back down. Simple. Well, as I have sat in that seat and listened to each of my peers speak to you all with confidence and inspiring words, I began to feel more and more anxious for when it was finally my turn. I started asking myself, what if my words aren't as impactful as theirs, or what if I say the wrong thing? My head began to fill with all of these negative and comparative thoughts, which, in all honesty, was not helpful at all. We all do it, every single one of us. Comparing yourself to someone else is part of human nature. From small thoughts in our head that happen subconsciously, like their clothes are way better than mine, to big things that really take a toll on us, like if only I had their body, their skin, their personality, if only I could just be more like them. Personally, as a teenage girl, I often find myself thinking about the if only, probably a bit too often, and constantly compare what I have to others. Today especially, with mainstream and social media constantly shoving images of perfect in our faces, it is extremely easy to compare ourselves to this idealistic standard which is frankly impossible to achieve. Because of this, we are always trying to change things about ourselves to try and accomplish that idea of perfect, when perfect doesn't actually exist. Our lives are not less fulfilling if we don't look a certain way or act a certain way. We need to stop trying to fix and change ourselves to suit others, because eventually we'll all realize that the real fix to the problem is accepting who we are as individual people. I think Dean Furness sums it up perfectly in his TED talk when he says that throughout our lives, we are constantly measured. When we are babies with our height and our weight, and as we grow up, it becomes our speed and our strength. Through to school when we are constantly tested and judged on our academic, cultural, and sporting performances and abilities. It seems as though these personal averages are almost always used to measure where we are in comparison to our peers. That personal average is just that. It's something very personal, and it's for you. If you focus on your averages and work to build that, you can really start to accomplish some amazing things. Comparison is also talked about in the Bible many times. See, we quite often hear that God has made us in his image, which is exactly that. Being true and loving ourselves is accepting what God has given us. He has given us all uniqueness and individuality, and he has created all of us with a specific purpose and plan. He has not made us to look the same or be good at the same things. When we look at the person next to us and wish for their gifts, we are sacrificing our ability to grow in the gifts God has given us. In other words, the more we try to be like someone else, the more we forget about who we are. In Psalm chapter 139, verse 14, it says, "I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works, my soul knows it very well." This verse reminds us that we are made in the eyes of God and that he created us all, one by one, in his image. To conclude, I guess I would just like to say, be yourself. Be yourself and be happy with yourself and the things that you do. Always remember that God made you in his image, not anyone else's. Learn to love what you have and learn to use those things for good. Thank you. We'll now have some music from a ukulele group consisting of Dan Williams and Seamus and Caitlin and Asher on guitar.
Upside down, who's just a thousand? this feeling to go upside down. I'll find the things they say just can't be found. I'll share this love I find with everyone. We'll sing and dance to Mother Nature's songs. I want this feeling to go away.
Fantastic. Thanks to Dan and Seamus and Caitlin and to Asher for that. Fantastic to have that in chapel this morning. Great to see the new chapel band back in. We haven't had a chapel band since 2003. So after a 19-year break, it's back amongst us. They'll be back every fortnight now with a new piece of music, with other instruments and other singers. And wonderful. So great to have the chapel band. There's going to be a significant prize as we name it, choose a name for it, give it an identity, and it'll come up with some interesting creative names. They didn't know any of that. Fantastic, that was wonderful. Thanks, guys. If we just go to the next slide now, we're actually, again, I've said it twice in a week, it's an absolute miracle, Anna first. We're early. Okay, we're early. It's not even quite quarter past eight yet, so I'm just going to hand over to mentor groups now, and to the staff there, our thanks to you and to the students in those groups. Just a chance to perhaps have a few minutes to reflect, to discuss, to chat through some of that messaging in Sam's talk this morning about comparison, how we compare ourselves to one another. Those of you who regularly use the chapel toilets will know that there's, in each of those two facilities, there's a poster I've stuck up on the towel dispenser. It's called Desiderata. It's a very powerful line in that, which goes, if you compare yourself to others, you will become vain and bitter. If you compare yourself to others, you will become vain and bitter. It's quite a powerful message in that longer piece of writing. Add that to Sam's messages, just over to you, just a few minutes to think about your identity, how we take our identity, and how happy are we inside our skin? How happy are we with the person we are and our uniqueness? There's only one of us, only one of you. Over to you, just for a few moments, and then after two or three minutes, we're going to play a wonderful piece of music from The Greatest Showman.
Almighty God, we give you thanks today that each one of us has been made in your image, individuals created for love and service. Lord, we give thanks that each and every one of us is utterly unique and no one else can be us or take our place. Help us today to realize and accept that, especially if we are struggling to fit in or find our place in this world. Help us to be confident and courageous versions of ourselves. Inspire us to be people who are not so concerned about fitting in, but rather to be discerning and discovering our own strengths. Encourage us to be ourselves and continue the lifelong work of being the best versions of ourselves. We pray this trusting and believing in your name, and all of God's people said amen. Amen. Amen.
As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we pray together the Lord's Prayer in Te Reo. E tō mā tō mātua I te rangi, kia tapu tō ingoa, kia tai mai tō rangatiratanga, kia metea tau e pai ai, ki runga ki te whenua, kia rite anō ki tō te rangi, hō mai kia mātou aia nei, he taro mā mātou mō tēnei rā, murua o mātou hara, me mātou hoki e muru nei, i o te hunga e hara ana kia mātou, aua hoki mātou e kawea kia whakawaia. Engari whakaorangia mātou I te kino, nō hoki te rangatiratanga, te kaha, me te karoria, ake, ake, ake. Āmine.
Kia ora, thanks Dan. Just a couple of notices from me. A, to say a big thanks to Sam. A powerful message today. I praise you for I am wonderfully and fearfully made. Powerful words from the Psalms. Those words written 3,000 plus years ago. And Sam opened those up once again to us today with her message. So thank you for that. And at the end of the day, it's always going to be about who you think you are and who God thinks you are. No one else really matters at the end. So just think on those and keep those words close as you proceed through the day, the week, rest of the term, and of course into the Easter holidays. Other messages from me. Again, thanks to all those who participated today. I understand the chapel band's already been signed up by the headmaster, and he's trying to poach them to be an assembly band. So there's what could be a battle of the bands going on here, and we'll see what happens. Perhaps we just need more bands. Service. Okay, finally, an opportunity for service. It won't be the most attractive one you've ever come across, but nonetheless, all service essentially is about sorting out generally the impact of other people's mess. And we've got a community cleanup. We're going to have a litter pick on Monday. So all those service-minded people, all those wonderful, wonderful, kind, generous, motivated, service-driven people out there, if you want to come and join in a community litter pick on Monday, meet me here at 12:30 outside the chapel. We've got plenty of gloves, we've got plenty of bags, and we've got plenty of people to help already, which is great. But come and join us. We'll meet here. I'll sort of sign you in a kind of way, and then we'll go across, grab lunch, have the lunch, and then we'll split up into some teams and go around the school site and have a bit of a cleanup. So that's Monday, 12:30, and I'll mention that again on Monday morning and at assembly, hopefully. So 12:30, meet here Monday, and then we're all off to lunch together, and then we're going to pick up some rubbish. It's a service opportunity. Like I said, it's not the most exciting one, perhaps, but of course, it's something we do need to do, and that's just what service is sometimes. Kia ora. So let's pray God's blessing upon us as we depart this folly into the day, into the rest of this week. So may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Mato, the Tama, the Walu, the Tapu, be upon us, be upon all those we love and care for and pray for, upon all those who make us possible. Amen. So let's conclude with the words of the grace of St. Paul. Kia tau, kia tato katoa, te atawhaia te tato ariki a ihu karaiti, me te alaha o te atua, me te whiwhina tahitanga, ki te waru tapu, ake, 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 amen. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all forever and ever. Amen. So let's go in the love of God, the peace of Christ, and the dignity of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Kia kaha, kia hali, kia tapu. Be strong, be happy, be holy. Amen. Have a fantastic day. Again, our thanks to Max, and now our thanks to Sean for the organ music as we depart. Kia ora.